People keep saying it looks like a movie. Airplanes striking the massive towers, the Pentagon. Members of Congress running for their lives. New Yorkers covered in dust and ash, their upturned faces shot with horror as the mighty structures crumble. Except for the fourth plane, wrestled by its passengers to the ground in western Pennsylvania, there's an infuriating perfection to the entire spectacle, which is part of what people mean when they speak of the Hollywood quality of the events. Like a movie, but different. The Siege, a movie I co-wrote. On August 7, 1998, Al-Qaeda attacked two American embassies in East Africa simultaneously, killing 224 people. More than 150 were blinded by the flying glass. Then on August 25th, another bomb went off, this one in a Planet Hollywood restaurant in Cape Town, South Africa. Few people remember that one. The death toll was small, two British tourists. A little girl lost her leg. A radical Islamist group claimed credit. They said they were protesting the trailers that had appeared in America for the siege. They struck Planet Hollywood because Bruce Willis, one of the co-stars of the movie, was a partial owner of the restaurant chain. The movie wasn't even out yet, but there was blood all over it. When it finally appeared in November 1998, 3 years before 9/11, Arab and Muslim protesters picketed the theaters, furious at being stereotyped as terrorists.
Ali Waziri, one of the bombers of Bus 87. We were able to trace this sucker to a...
Then, in the month following 9/11, it was the most rented movie in America, making me the first profiteer in the war on terror. Yes, it's like a movie. It's like my movie. We were wounded, we were shaken and confused, but many of us in America had the feeling that we were going to be new people after 9/11, better because of the need to stand for something, for true American values. It was our turn now to show the world what America represented, an enduring force for good.